Hey guys, it's Aldo. I thought I would try to make short video updates in this format. So let me know if you like this and I should keep going. So today I wanted to discuss about the brand architecture review that I've been discussing. And this is something that is our number one priority at the moment, and we have made a lot of good progress recently. So this is the first part, and I will first discuss what is this in general about, and then in another video we will go more into details about our findings and conclusions. So the brand architecture is kind of the structure of the brands, of the brand portfolio. And the whole intention is to package products together so that we clarify and communicate our offerings. And as a result, the goal is to then drive the brand recognition. And this is an image I found the most helpful to provide a high-level summary about what type of structures there are for branding. The monolithic model follows a naming convention where the parent brand is heavily leveraged, like Google Books, Google Groups, and so on. Endorsed brand means, on the other hand, that there's still a strong, also some sort of connection to the parent brand, but there might be like a logo. It might use different colors or fonts or have kind of its own unique style, but is still associated with the parent brand. Then freestanding brand means that there's completely no relation to the parent brand, and to the consumer, it might not be clear that there's a parent brand behind that product brand, such with the, for example, with the bumpers example. And then there can be a combination of these, which is then a hybrid model. So in the past week, we have been doing an analysis of our situation. What are our product brands? What are we offering? And how are we positioning them? And this was roughly the result. So we have DPAO, this monolithic, understood direction the Komodo, associated with the Komodo parent brand. We have smart chains, and here it's kind of unclear if this is even a product brand or just a term we use, but I just put it here just to showcase that there's some confusion. Then we have the Antara framework, which is, I see as endorsed product brand because we are using different logo and it's kind of talk independently. That is the just referenced as Antara. And underneath it we have Antara modules, Antara composer, and so on. Then for the user side we have the atomic decks. This is currently freestanding, very loose connection to Komodo. Although people generally know that it's from Komodo, it's not really promoted that way in our branding, so that's why I put it to the freestanding category. And then lastly, we have been announcing how we have vision to launch this another developer-related product that we were codenamed Atomic DeFi. And now that we added this story, this was the catalyst to kind of let's hold on a moment and review the branding situation today, because there's clearly a sort of confusion and problems. So as a result of this analysis, we kind of have concluded that we have been overbranding Komodo, and there's a lot of brand obfuscation that our community often is complaining about, that things are a bit confusing. So now, as the first effort going forward, we are going to find a clear solution to this and remove this brand obfuscation. And based on this, then we are able to start doing like actual marketing and marketing campaigns and start to communicate more clearly about what we have and what we are offering. So going forward with our proposal, we have a guiding policy to simplify the overall structure. We will tie everything closer to Komodo brand, and that was our goal originally. And we are also looking to not start from scratch. We are not looking to destroy what's already built. So we are trying to find a way that lets us leverage like the existing brand recognition, for example, like we have with Atomic Dex already. So this was the end of the part one. I'd like you to come to our Discord and share your ideas on the channel there. But what do you think about this? Like, do you have ideas? And then on a later video, soon, I will be revealing our conclusions and proposal for the new brand architecture that will bring a lot more clarity into what product brands we are offering and how what they are, who they are for, and so on. Talk to you on Discord.